Okay, so we should be alive here momentarily. All right. So, I did a let's look at of this game a while ago, and I am thinking I'm going to try and do this for a live stream today. So, I don't think I didn't have the sound on my headset. Now, is that just because it's here? Okay, let's reset. Actually, wow, that is surprisingly loud. Let's maybe go to options first and master did that. Seem to change it all that much. So I'm gonna have to actually crank it down here. Let's try and do like negative, roughly negative 15 decibels. How's that? Seems a bit better, but I'm going to crank it down actually to negative 20. And that seems pretty good. Okay, back. We will reset. Okay, loading BIOS, salvage vessel, cargo class, version 5.1. Passive control systems, pass. Navigation, pass. Engineering, pass. System diagnostics, fail. Critical warnings, fuel. Fuel low, 6 days. Crew size, one. We will launch our. Wait, why is it so quiet now? Oh, maybe it hadn't reset there yet? So. Okay. Let's go with that. And, maybe crank that all the way back up now that. Maybe. Still seems like really quiet though. Okay. Okay, actually, let's up. Okay, well. Leave it like that. Okay. And we will board this ship here. We have Ron, who has motion, which is fantastic. I love motion, as well as gather. We also have Tim with generator and Brandon with tow and stealth. Ooh, those are some lovely starting drones. Okay, scanning inconclusive, infection types detected zero, hull integrity good, name Cold Comfort 2, class directive exploration crew 6, hold 15 scientists, 7,330 or 73,337, communications found in archive 65. Okay, so not all of them are corrupted this time. We will go to drone number one and open up. A1. See what there all is. There's one piece of scrap, a generator, and an open door. Okay. So what we are going to want to do here. That's not what I want. Just put my phone down. Should not be interacting with the phone while on here. Gathered. And then we will go back to this view. We will have navigate to R2 and then have him generator. Okay, all the doors are now powered. Navigate 1 to R3. See what's all going on in there. There's a broken down drone. Just gonna make sure that there's nothing else going on in here other than that. It doesn't appear to be. Okay. Let's swap. He has a stun. Drops proximity stun mine. Ooh, that could be very useful. We will definitely take that. Okay, go back to this view. We will open up D2. And then we will follow that with a navigate 1 R5. And since we don't know anything else about that room yet, we will just proceed with those actions. Some couple of things in here. Oh, and we almost missed out on some fuel because our little drone guy didn't see it otherwise. So, you will now gather all. And then, no fuel collected. Excellent. And, follow that up with a D5 with a navigate 1 to R4. Literally just the one scrap in here. Okay. Gather. Not gather. Gather. And then, we will navigate all to R1. Did update the stream, right? I feel so I did, but I'm just gonna double check that first. And then we will exit. First ship, very successful. We gathered 0 fuel, but we got 4 scraps, and we now have the stun module added to Ron. Now, what do we want to go to next? Do we want to go to this one? Salvage C. Salvage are usually pretty good. Infestation types 1. Visit falls. Capacity 50. What about this one? Barge B. Scrap capacity. And then K. K is distance 3. It's also a barge. We should probably go to this one first, I'm thinking. Yeah, we'll do this one first. So, we will travel there, and then we will board it. And I think I'll hold on to the stun module for right now. See how we hold with that. Okay, initial vessel report scanning, scrap found in room R2. Updating schematic. Infection types 1 detected. Hull integrity good. Name Myron Ob 2. Class Directive Royal Transport. Crew 1. Hold unknown. 18,446 communications found in archive, and all of them are corrupted. No uncorrupted communications found. So, seeing as how these first couple of shifts shifts. Ships are somewhat scripted. I will start with opening that up and exploring this room because this one shouldn't have enemies in it. I could have done a motion just to be 100% certain on that, but I figured we are probably safe going with what we are doing at the moment. Okay, so go back to this view, gather all, and then we will move or navigate. I should put a space there. Navigate to our three, and then generator. And then navigate 1, 2, or 4. Now we don't actually see what's going on in there, right? In R2, do we? Oh, no. I don't get to actually see what's going on in there, so. And we will do a navigate 1, 2, R3, followed by a motion. Okay, so hostiles are in R5. Seems so we've already heard strategic option. Heard enemies in rooms R2 or by opening doors, D7. You know what I'm gonna do? I am not gonna follow that advice, and instead gonna do, nope, not D12, D10, followed by a D8, and then ready to close D8. Okay, and they are all in there now. This is why motion is so important, if you can get it on your first drones. Okay, so what we will do now is we will open up D4 by navigating 1, 2, R2, followed by a gather all, followed by a D5, followed by a navigate 1, 2, R5. So I think this should all work the way I want it to. We got 1 day of fuel and 0 jump. Fair enough. I'm pretty sure I said gather all. Okay, so that didn't quite work out the way I wanted it to. Did I not say gather all before? Okay, navigate 1, 2, R5. And here there is a drone that we could use. So what we do here, we navigate 3, 2, R5. We then follow that up with a tow, followed with a navigate 3, 2, R1. In the meantime, we will have a we will open up D3 with a navigate 1, or actually we can't even navigate 1 over there except for manually. So we will open up D3, go back to drone number 1. Wow, the camera was all kinds of messed up there for a little bit. I don't want to dock A2 from the screen to redock here. Dock. Okay, so we will gather all, followed by a navigate all to R1, and this should work. No. Number one, stop navigating. Okay, so that didn't work the way I wanted it to. Gather all. Okay, so now we navigate one to R1. Okay, fair enough. Starting to learn the controls a little bit better. It seems you can't do like two all commands within close proximity of each other. We will exit. And that went rather swimmingly. We got one P-Fuel, we collected 10 scrap, and we added one drone to our fleet, whose name is Cliff, and he has the shield module on him. So if we go to drone config, we really need to bring this guy back to the land of the living. So we go to modifications for that. Prepare full 9 scrap to do that, but I definitely think it is worth it. Execute. Every extra drone you have, I say, helps quite a bit. So distance 2 or distance 2. Barge B. Fist of God 2. Or Lord Gwydion 2. Only one infestation type for both of them. This one's a little bit smaller. I think I'll go to the smaller one first. And we will board. We will move you into our active drones. And maybe move that one out and give you stun. Not sure what the exclamation mark denotes. Hopefully nothing too bad. And we will board the ship. So what do we know about this one? Initial vessel report. Scanning. Dormant drone found in room R2. Updating schematic. Infection types detected 1. Hull integrity good. Name Lord Gwydion 2. Class. Directive prisoner transport. Crew 6. Hold 41 prisoners. 33,656 communications found in archive. Only 32,653 corrupted. Begin communication. Intranet log accepted. Load report. Security contract. Follow the agreed security contract with H5 secure all current security sector workers on US and UK based ships are required to reapply for their posts. New staff who are current employees of H5 secure to be deployed as a foundational force starting in February. Current policing duties outside of Earth's orbit are conducted by H5 Secure. And transmission enter. So we have the broken down drone in R2. So what do we want to do? Let's open up with a motion. Media room to our left is good. We'll open up A1 and move over into here. See what all is going on. D4 is closed. We found a generator. D5 is closed. There's a panel here that we could communicate with if we had the appropriate module, but we don't. And nothing in D3. All right, so what do I do with this information? I go back to this view. I navigate 2 to R3, followed by a generator, followed by a motion, I think. So we have hostiles in D5. We can detect that, apparently. Other than that, though, we don't have any other information at this point. So, what I think I will do is... What happens if I... Why don't I get motion for... Or is it because... Okay. I'm gonna try something here. Hopefully it works. 10. Followed by D3. So they move out of R5 in a moment here, right? Yeah, out of R5. They'll go into whatever room is in between D10 and D3. And then I'm not sure if it'll pop up in R4 if they move into there. I'll find out in a little bit. Or what happens if I do D10 again? Give them no choice but to go into R4. Can I motion again? What happens if I motion again? Motion. Results inconclusive for R4 and R2. I don't like that a whole lot. So what happens if I were to open D5, then we'll switch to guy number 4 here who has the shield. Even though there's nothing going on in there, I don't want to get wrecked by like a random turret or something in here. Okay, so there is a turret there. It's deactivated at this point of time. So we don't even need the shield on at the moment. So what we will do from here, we'll navigate 1 to R5. And then we'll motion again once we're in here. Okay, so they are in D2 and D10. Oh, snap. Okay. Oh, but they're moving from those rooms. Okay, so we'll close D3. I don't know how I feel about all this information. Not knowing what is behind door 10 or door 2. Let's just gather all for a moment. We'll go back to drone number 4, shield. We will open up door 8, because there shouldn't be anything in here other than this broken down drone. And I think it's worth trying a swap here. He has teleport. Teleports drone to specified room as well as mine. Drops a proximity mine. I think I'll take mine for this guy. And then we'll move you out of here for a minute. And we'll navigate 3. And we'll navigate 3 to room 2. And then have him go. And then have him navigate 3 to R1. We'll try that on for size, see how that works. Oh, crud. 3. No. I forgot, that's not an towable one. I wanted to swap for the teleport, that's right. Teleport. And then you can navigate back to three to R1 again. Okay, so what do we do from here? From R5, we get information on D10 and D2, but we don't get information. So what happens if I navigate 1 to R2, and then we'll have him motion in here. Nothing's going on in D7, at least right now. I'll give it a good, like, okay, yeah, so there's something has access to D7 right now. So I'll navigate 4 to R2. Still has the shield active. So enter. So okay, then move back out. D7. Okay. So, no. So sensors have been activated in there. Oh, lordy, lordy, lord. I cannot power or unpower those rooms at the moment. So, and this is a waste of a lot of motions here, but I can always repair them later on, if need be. Navigate 1 to R5, followed by a motion. So now we switch back to 4 for a moment here. There's stuff going on in whatever room that is. I think it's safe to open D10 at the moment. Just pop our head in here real... Oh, there's nothing in here. But there is a generator, which is pretty big for us. Because then we can probably power up the R6 room. So, this is what we're going to do. We are going to navigate 2 to R7. And then we will have them generate in there, which should give us access to all of these rooms that I want access to. Okay, so what I can do is the second that one room is clear of hostiles, we close the doors to D6, see what's going on in D2. Okay. That was a little frightening there. The door wasn't wanting to close there. We'll open up D2 and see what's going on in here with our drone first and foremost. There is some fuel that is big and quite a bit of scrap. We will move back over to here. We will navigate one to our eight and have him gather all in there. We don't have motion at the moment, but we shouldn't need it for the time being. So he's gonna gather the fuel, hopefully something one day propulsion and one jump. Oh, that is big. That is actually so big. And then we will navigate one back to our five. Start motion again in there. And yeah, that for right now. And then we will close D2, open up D6, and get ready to close D6 when hostiles move into R8. Okay, now what we do is we move drone number 4. His shield is still active. So what we do here, we open up door 7. Should be safe to explore in here. Only one more scrap, that's fine. I can live with that. So we go back to here, navigate one to R6. We then gather. And then we navigate all back to R1. Wait, what? Navigate all to R1. There we go. I'm gonna get ready to exit, but don't actually press enter until all of our drones are inside and have stopped moving. Good. We can exit. That went swimmingly. We collected 1J fuel and 1P fuel. We collected 6 scrap. Could have been a little bit better, but that's fine. We acquired a teleport upgrade as well as a mine upgrade. Those are also pretty darn big, I must say. So other than that, we will continue. And it might be a little bit embarrassing to admit, but I don't think I've ever made it this far before. Just want to see how the stream looks right now. Stream looks fine. Stream looks better than fine. It looks great. I'm happy with that. Okay. So we will pop this back open. We have how much scrap total? 13. I don't think we can do a whole lot with 13 right now, other than I could repair it. Or we could add an additional 25. Am I reading that right? No, that can't be right. I'm just gonna try it. Okay, so it didn't do what I thought it was, and it was just more or less a waste of 2 scrap. Which is fine. I am okay with that. I learned something. We will go to the Fist of God next, which kind of frightens me. But we are on the Justice Rider, with a Y for Rider. That's pretty freaking sweet. Actually, you know what? I probably should do this real quick while, broadcasting disabled. Just so I don't have someone jump in here real quick and eat up bandwidth that I don't need them to. Return, and we will travel to this ship. And we will board it. And we are ready to board. From this point on, it is unknown territory. Scanning. Dormant drone found in room R2. Updating schematic. Infection types detected. 1. Hull integrity good. Name. Fist of God 2. Awesome name for a ship. Almost as good as the Justice Rider. Directive. Military patrol. Crew. 7. Hold. 16 government employees. 8,815 communications found in archive. 8,815 are corrupted. No uncorrupted. Blah, 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 blah. Okay, start off with a motion. Nothing found in that sector. Cool. So we open up A1. We move out with Ron to start off with. Okay, room D15 is open. We have a generator here. We have a door to D9 open. Let's see what's going on in here. Room to D8 is closed. Another generator and some scrap. Lots of doors. We'll gather this real quick. And let's take a look at what our map looks like here real quick. Okay. So, I think we move you over to room 3 and generate that one just for this second, and we'll do a motion real quick here. So no hostiles in room 2. We don't know about room 5, though. So, what do we do with this information? I think what I do here is, knowing that there's hostiles in room 6, but they're trapped in room 6, what I do, first and foremost, is I navigate Ron to room 3 real quick. And then I'll have him motion in there as well, just to see what's going on in room 5, just to be safe. Because I don't want to open the floodgates to room 5. Okay, nothing going on in room 5. So, we open up door 9. We explore that. There is a ship upgrade. This is new for me. Ship defense, control upgrade. Ship upgrade, remote power. Use toad. Okay. So, what we do here, and I finally get to test it out, we teleport 3 to R5. Oh, it totally worked. We tow and then tow it, or now this is the question though. Okay, we get him to tow the upgrade, and then what happens if we teleport 3 to room 1 if he has, okay, so that doesn't work. That's fine. I wasn't expecting it to work 100%. So we teleport 3 to R5, followed by a tow, followed by a navigate, 3, 2, R1. Okay, so that all works. Navigate, 1, oh, jeez. Ah! Navigate, 3, 2, R1. And then we'll have you move into here real quick. Okay, we got 2 scrap and a ship upgrade now. So we will motion. We will open up the floodgates to room 11. And get ready to close 11 shortly after, hopefully. You gonna investigate room 5 there, buddy? Yeah? Come on, you know you wanna go. Yeah, there we go. Okay, so room 6 should be safe to go into. Should be is the key word here. So we will open up door 10, switch back to you, see what all is going on in here. Another terminal which I can't access, unfortunately. Oh, and some fuel. Okay, got it. Okay, 1 day and 0 jump. It's fine if we don't get any more jump than what we have. It's just a little disappointing. Okay, so door 12 should be safe to open. We'll go into here. See what all we have going on in here. We have another airlock that we could access. Now that is interesting. And another drone we could also bring back with us as well, actually. That's also very interesting. Which I think I might just do. Report. 3, 2, R2. And then follow that with a tow, followed with a navigate 3 to R1. No. You're supposed to tow this thing. There we go, and navigate 3 to R2. Navigate 3 to R1. There we go. Oh, jeez. Motion. We only have information on the room behind D4. So what do we do with this information now? I think we navigate drone 2 to room 4 and follow that up with a generator. Which I think should give us access to... Yeah, it gives us access to all those rooms. D4 should be safe to go into. Or, room 9 should be safe to go into. So, we'll open up that door. There's a single scrap. Gather. We will scan again here. Or, motion. We don't have information here. Okay. Navigate 1, 2, R4, followed by a motion. Just because I don't trust room 8 or room 7 without having any information whatsoever on them. And there's actually 3 airlocks here, surprisingly enough. Please let me get okay, so we have information on room 7. It's good to go into. So D14. You can go into here and please tell me I can oh jeez. Okay, I'm back. Just a crazy dog. And we will do a motion here. We still don't get information on room 8. So, with this information, what I do is we navigate one back to room 4. We close D14 and we open up D, or we motion first and then open up D6. See if hostiles move into, and that's what I thought. I knew I couldn't trust it. We now open up door 5, followed by a navigate 1 to room 8. And after that, we should be in the clear for the rest of the ship. We should have inspected every last nook and cranny, made sure we aren't missing anything valuable or anything like that. Oh, come on, there has to have been some. Well, still, I'm glad I went about things the way I did. We'll navigate all to room 1. Really hope we find a drone that has operate soon, because we're running into a lot of missed opportunities with these consoles. Like leading enemies into rooms with power down turrets that we could use to just get rid of them completely. Oh well, not the end of the world. Collected 1 P fuel, we only collected 6 scrap, surprisingly enough. And we got a new drone, Brandon, who has Pry in mind. But the big thing here is we have the ship upgrade remote power. Break probability 0.00%. Love that. Use ship config menu to install a new ship upgrade. So what does this do? Remotely powers a power inlet. That is actually so huge. We will definitely take that. And we now get to go to the all objects in the system have been explored, press 2 or space to view other systems. So we have a few new systems we can go to now. We could go to this system, which has 7 objects, this one which has 6, that one which has 4, this one which has 7, or this one which has 2. Also costs 2 fuel to go over there, which brings me a little bit, but I should only be, let's sort of do a bit of a circle here. Start with the BATA, or Vent Space Vent Sax Jet, Kali, Talon Tin Suyu, or Tarsis. Let's go to BATA. There's lots of options over there. And I like the sound of its jib. Jump over there. Every time you jump between systems, your propulsion fuel recharges. Note, this does not apply to your reserve tank. Interesting. That is very good to know. Okay. We will go back to the system here. Okay, so we have a lot of options here. We have a Stargate. We have a Tech One. We have a quarantined off barge with That is 222 years old, very volatile, two infestation types. Oh, I'm probably gonna skip that one entirely. Island's also volatile, 224 years old. But if we could make this one our main ship, then that would be good. Distance tubes. So what's the Stargate mean then? We also have this one, which is a space station. Okay, so not all of these are hostile. It's only ones that are like 200 years or older that are volatile. Infestation types unknown. Jeez Louise. Basically all these are volatilely aged. The question is, where do we want to start here? Okay, what does this Stargate do? I can board the Stargate? Apparently. Oh, and it lets me go to a different system. Or, oh, to another universe. Oh. But I don't think I want to be messing around with that quite yet. Okay. The question here now is, do we go to a stable ship with two infestation types, or a single one, or tech ship with one infestation type, but is volatile? Okay, encoding is going up like crazy. We're fine again. I think the answer here is we'll try the volatile ship, seeing as it only has one infestation type, and we'll go with that for now. And we will board it. So shield or pry. Oh, we didn't even recover him. Honestly, he doesn't have a whole lot I'm super interested in, so I think I just scrap this new one. I don't need it. We'll just convert it to scrap. Remote power. And I'm probably not going to use these modules, so magnetic clamp. Interesting, but I think unnecessary at this time. What else can we do with some of these? Here's the upgrade, costs 10. Radiation-proof shield. Oh, that's pretty nice. Adds an auto-charge mod to the shield at the expense of a lower maximum health. I don't think we need that. But I like the sound of anti-radiation. So we'll give it anti-radiation. And we'll also repair it, I think. Just because I don't want it to fail on me, if possible. Teleport sensors and traps dropped in room to any other room in the ship. Wait, no, I don't think that does what I think it does. No, it doesn't. We don't need to add 25 motion sensors as of yet. We could add magnetic clamps to these, but I haven't really had to use them yet. So we will ignore those, and we will now actually board this ship. Yes. Scanning. Dormant drone found in room R2. Obtained schematic. Infection types detected 2. Hull integrity medium. Name Lycorhynus. Yeah, Lycorhynus. Class Tech C. Directive exploration. Crew 6 hold 19 scientists. 68,740 communications found. All of them are corrupted. Okay. Oh, there's 2 ship upgrades in room 2. Oh, I need those, but first of all, motion. First room is safe. Without question. Without a doubt in my mind. Okay. So, from here, we motion again. We don't get information on any of the rooms I would like, unfortunately. So we will navigate to R3 and followed by a generator. Please be able to squeeze past him. Please, please, please. Okay. Fine, we'll move you up into here. Another console that I can't access. Okay. And, generator. Okay. Motion. Nothing. Wait. Why are icons? Okay. Oh, I was a little confused there for a moment, but we're fine again. We'll open up D4 because apparently that is safe. If hostiles were able to enter there, I'm sure they would have by now. Okay. Hold on just a moment. Okay, I am back. What was I doing here? I think I was just looking around in this room, seeing if there was literally anything, which there does not appear to be a single thing of worth in here. So let's motion in here. We don't get any information on any of those rooms, and I don't think we got information in room three either. Like navigate one to room three. Yeah, it sounds like these that I really wish we hadn't drone with operate. Okay, let's motion. Yep, we don't get any information on any of the important rooms. I can't believe that only. Oh, that makes me mad that we only power up literally two rooms with that generator. Okay, so what do we do with our information that we have right now? I think what we have to do is we bring this guy into here. We put up his shield. We open up door 9. Yep, okay, so door 9. Nope. So, we know that there is something somewhere now, and we don't have power to any of the doors. Well, this turned pretty bad real quick. Navigate ship to A3. Okay. How do I? How do I get help again? Help. Okay. Ship upgrade. Basic commands. Commands. Oh, okay. So what we should maybe try and do here is, but I still think it's, I think we just have to exit. Just have to exit. That was botched. I could have done a lot better with that. But I didn't have a whole lot of options either. I don't know. I think I'm actually gonna end the stream here. Thank you for anyone who tuned in. It was lovely having you all. And I may be on tomorrow again. I don't know. In the meantime, though, have a good one, and I'll see you later. Bye.